movie.
So are you.
The two of us.
We are in a movie called Date Night.
Look at these two lovebirds.
No. Ma'am, first date.
Nope, he has a ring on. They both do.
Mm-mm. No. Married?
They're not married.
They're sitting on the same side of the booth.
That is not a married move.
We play a couple from New Jersey who are very nice and regular people, and they want to go and have one nice, fun night out away from their kids, and it gets all screwed up.
Okay, walk me through this again.
Hun.
Honey, if I'm gonna get whacked off, I at least deserve to understand why it's happening. What are you smiling about?
No, you're very sweet. We're not going to get whacked off.
I think we are.
What happens in this movie, Dave?
Glad you asked. Well, Claire and Phil Foster, mm-hmm. played by us, mm-hmm. go out on a date night to sort of rekindle the relationship. Mm-hmm. It's not a bad relationship. It's just a relationship that I think has grown a little stale,
right.
perhaps. Mm-hmm. And two very loving people, two kids, and they decide to kind of cut loose and go into New York, not have their average date night.
Mm-hmm. I have a potato on my fork. I like to eat potatoes. They're delicious, but I don't actually ever put them in my mouth.
That's amazing, Jeremy, but I'm gonna go home now and fart into a shoebox.
Doesn't make sense.
They have trouble getting a table at a very fancy restaurant that your character really wants us to have a special night,
right.
at this fancy restaurant in the city. You lie, and we take someone else's reservation, and we say we're this other couple called the Triplehorns, and we take their reservation and have a really nice meal. But then at the end of the meal, some kind of scary guys come in looking for the Triplehorns and mistake us for them. And then we have to run for our lives.
Run for our lives all night long. There's a fair bit of intrigue, mm-hmm. that this couple gets wrapped, mm-hmm. up in.
I can't believe out of hundreds of clients, you remember this one guy.
Well, I've always been good with names and faces.
It's amazing you have recall like that, honey. All the people you see to be able to remember one.
Claire Foster.
Holbrook Grant. Listen, we're in some trouble and we really need help.
Yeah, sure, why not? Come on in.
There are a lot of great people in this movie.
Mm-hmm.
We have Ray Liotta.
Mm-hmm.
We have Mila Kunis.
Mm-hmm.
We have
James Franco. Mark Wahlberg.
Tell me what. Now, when you first read the script, did you envision any of these people? Or did you have specific notions as to who these characters would be?
I did think that they were really good parts when I read the script. I thought, oh, these are really good parts for some people. But I don't know that I thought we would get this lucky.
Yeah.
To have that caliber of people in all these different parts. How about you?
I feel the same way. It's hard sometimes when you read a script and they're great characters, but you don't necessarily know who would play them, and then when you see them acted out, they're even better than, mm-hmm. they would have been on the page. I think we've lucked out.
I play Holbrook Grant, who is kind of like this kind of crazy security expert who they come to for help, and they catch me at a bad time. I'm in between my fifth and sixth sex session with my beautiful Israeli girlfriend. And they're looking for help, and they kind of end up turning my night upside down.
Man, you guys are lucky to be alive. You're right, Claire. I would stay away from the cops.
Which is why we were hoping that you would help us.
Well, it's the least I can do. I mean, you are so patient with me. All those long drives up and down the turnpike.
It was my pleasure. And this is definitely the right place for you. I bet the ladies love it, too, right?
I do all right.
Well, goodbye.
Goodbye.
And don't worry.
Don't worry.
Makes no sense at all.
Just see Date Night. Go on a date night and see Date Night.
Tina Fey.
Steve Carroll.
Oh.
Forgot. You don't have to be married to go on a date night.
Nope. You could be divorced.
You could go with your teacher.
You could go with your kids.
Mm-hmm.
You could go with your grandparents.
Your pastor.
Your rabbi.
You could go with a Build-A-Bear if you buy a ticket for that bear.
You could. I wouldn't.
You could go with...
You should just go.
Just go.